Hey guys, so I think I'm live and I think everything's working okay. Microphone should be fine. I said I was supposed to go on at 7:30 today because I didn't want to come off too late and I ended up being late logging on anyway. So yeah. We're going to be carrying on with the Flamingo, as my kiddo likes to call them. And I don't know how much we're going to get done today, but I'm hoping we get a good portion. Hey! Yeah, I'm hoping we're going to get the neck done and probably start on the first part of the body, I imagine. Fingers crossed. How are you, John? By the way, it's been a day for accidents, so it wouldn't surprise me if something goes tragically wrong, but let's hope it doesn't. I can't even remember in what order I used what pencils last time, so this should be interesting. Yeah, I don't remember at all. Go with instinct here. Yeah, I'm not too bad. It's been one of them days where you just don't feel like you're on this planet. Do you get them? I get them all the time. You just feel a little bit quirky. I did warn everybody in the group today that I was going to be on a bit earlier than normal. So hopefully people aren't going to be too upset as it's out of the routine. Must get into the habit of using my blue tack. I get really annoyed with the fallout you get with erasers. They're really frustrating. So typically, it's half term, and what's it doing outside? Raining. I swear they have a half term every other week. I'm going to be a bit all over the place because I'm trying to settle back into drawing this. It's the only downside to doing them on multiple live feeds, whereas I would probably leave it only a day or two between each session on the drawing. But because I've left it so long in between, it gets a bit, you sort of forget where you are as such. It does seem like that, doesn't it? It's all a bit odd and weird and, yeah, a bit higgledy-piggledy. Right, I should just do my share out quickly. I find that at the minute, the only way to get it out there is if I'm sharing everywhere I can without annoying people. I'm trying so hard to reach the next subcategory, which is 1,600, I think. And I've been sat on the same number now for so long. I'm trying to edge it up slowly. So let me just do my shares, because that's really what you want to watch me doing right now, isn't it? I hate the way every time I go to put in live feed, it always puts love feed. That's a whole different category right there. Oh, there's always excuses. There's an excuse for everything, don't you know? No, I do not want a direct message. No, I do not want a direct message. Wake up, Bonnita. I told you, it's just one of them days. I can't even type the word hi, apparently. I'm trying to keep it away from my LED, because it washes some of the colour out if you're not careful. I'm waiting to save up. I'm hoping with my next Patreon, I've been using Patreon to pay for equipment to be able to make the videos better. So the next Patreon payout, I'm hoping that I can get some of their big LED like studio lights. And then that way I'm not having to have about 50 different lights on around the office just to get you to be able to see it properly. Especially as with this sort of drawing, you don't want it to end up looking really, really washed out, and you don't want to lose the colours. And especially with white LED, you need natural light LED. I think it's something like 5,800 lumens or something like that. So yeah, I'm saving up. So hopefully once I get the better lighting, I can make better quality videos, which hopefully then means more subs on the channel. God, there's so many highlights in here. I'm just going to very loosely draw around where all these highlights are. Being a perfectionist either as to exactly where everything is placed. I just want to give the indication, because it's occasions like this actually where people say, why bother drawing it when you can take a photo? But we as artists choose what we want to add and what we want to leave out. So I think it's fair, losing my voice now. I think this is the joy of doing these, is that you can show that actually you can do it as you like. And although it may look like a photo, it may not look like the photo that you were originally using. Trouble with having these lights at the moment as well is it's actually quite difficult to see which pencils you're picking up. very moany cat today as well, so you may just hear them. Dee Dee's got a proper little moan on. I nearly started this again because I was really annoyed with the fact that I didn't redraw the image when I realised that I'd done it too far up. But I'm quite tempted to actually put some text down the bottom. Haven't quite decided yet. Still on the fence. Catastrophe here. Yeah, she's been a proper moany mini today. They're renowned for being noisy and eating plastic. Which is why I have to be really, really careful when I wrap my originals up. Because I put them in clear cellophane bags, I can't leave them on my desk. And I have to hide my tape behind a curtain because she will sit there and eat it all. Because she's a little bit weird. But apparently it's quite common for their breed. Hi, Pam. I could magically turn it into a 10x8 or something. The colours aren't too bad through the camera today, but I literally have one LED light ring shining on my work. Tell you what, I'm so grateful to have that Patreon there, because if I didn't, I wouldn't be able to have half the equipment I do at the moment. So yes, typically when the girls are at school, it's beautiful and sunny and doors are open, and then of course half term comes around and bam, the heavens open. This is really quite fiddly. All these shadows and highlights. What's the matter, Dee Dee? What's the matter? What? Whatty? Yes. Okay, we've got a little highlight down here. As I say, I'm not going to be precise or exact because I just don't want to. I'm going to be a lazy artist and I'm going to do whatever I find at the moment makes my job a bit easier. Dee Dee. Oh, she's just gone right behind the computer. If any cables drop out, I'm blaming her. Dee Dee, what are you doing? We're going to be invaded by a cat. Yes, thank you very much. Apologies. Dee Dee, away from my light, please. Dee Dee, come on. We're being a bit of a pain now, aren't we? Yes. No, that's my pencil. What are you doing? What? What are you doing? Come on. Got an invasion on the drill and on the desk. If it's not kids, it's cats. There's no way you found plastic to eat. Go on, move it. Come on. Okay, so the highlights look a complete mess at the moment, but it's not until we really start building them up that they won't look such a mess. So I just got a layer and layer and layer basically. Now what's she eating? Dee Dee! Apologies, that was right in the microphone. She's right behind my computer. I'm hoping she's not chewing on anything. I used purple before for the shadows, but I think I'm just going to go in with this grey instead. Right, we're taking the Michael now a bit, love, aren't we? Come on. We need to get down. Come on. Good girl. Never work with animals and children. Okay, so this is one of those reasons and times you would keep your pencil semi-blunt, because it makes for blending easier. Very quiet tonight. So where is everybody? Never work with people, that's actually pretty true. I just need to darken these a little bit before I go over them. Hopefully, once we get enough layers on there, the colour of that's annoying me. It should be a much more vibrant pink, and I think where I've used a colour to try and darken it, it's sort of ruined it a little bit actually. So I'm having to look at it through my recording because it's actually easier to see where you have gone right or wrong. It's part of the reason actually why I tell people to take a picture as they do progress through their picture, because it actually helps you work out whether or not you need to go darker in your contrast, whether the colors are right, and you can generally pick things out that you wouldn't normally. It's like the whole thing of walking back from a canvas while you're painting. There's things that you notice when you step away that you don't notice when you're really close up, and you need to look at it as a whole rather than when you're constantly looking down on your work. You're only looking at it as pieces, whereas once you step back or take a photograph or look at it through, in my case, the monitor, then you get a good overall picture. Yeah, go on. Why not? Where is everybody tonight? This is what happens when you start earlier. Confuse people. It's been a day of starting early stuff, actually. Oh, yeah. I've always envied those that can airbrush. I've never been, I've never got the hang of it. God, it's so dark in here. I don't know if I'm anywhere near the right colours. Let's put that down for a moment. I used to have an airbrush kit when I was much younger, and I don't think I ever really got it. There was no YouTube to watch and search for, and internet to look up tutorials back then. It just shows actually how reliant we've become on online resources. It's also incredible in the fact that, you know, if you want to know anything, that the first place you go is the internet. And, you know, there aren't many questions out there that there isn't an answer for. Quite mind-boggling, boggling, really, if you think about it. Yeah, pop it up in the group. I'm surprised you haven't. Hi, Joanne. I was late too, so it's obviously in the air. I'm not going to tell you off. God, I really am not doing it like the reference whatsoever. As long as it looks like a reflection, I don't really care. There are some highlights which are literally just white, so that's exactly how I'm gonna keep them. I just need to sharpen that now. Some tiny little, might even have to use the dark one for that actually. Well, you can now sit back, relax, and enjoy. I'm probably going to go to around 8:30, 9 o'clock. Okay, right, this bit needs making much larger. Okay, and we've got make that a bit darker in there. I love it when you start getting the last few layers on and it just all goes on so smoothly. You can't see any of that paper and it's lush. Ah, that's great news. Feels nice, doesn't it, when you can get going again. Hi, Erica. I need to keep remembering to keep my page on camera. I might tilt you actually slightly so I can bring it down a little bit more without panicking. You've come off. There we go. So you can really see the richness of the colour when I move it away from the light. God, how's my coffee got so cold already? Okay, so I just need to close the gaps as such and make the highlights on here much more prominent. Get the shapes a bit more like they are in the reference. I'm not going to be absolutely 100% anal over this. I'm just going to get them in roughly. Done there, but that needs to like so. Right, let's make sense of this. This solid in here. You do realize that the only time I actually talk to myself like this is when you lot are there. I'm just trying to stop it from being really boring and quiet for you. You'll soon get back into it. I used to put up my pic on the group. Is that the art share? Yes, put it in the art share group. Show everybody. That's why we're there, because we like seeing all the pretty pictures. Just gonna pull away a little bit of that colour. That's better. Oh, what are you doing, Dee Dee? What are you doing, darling? What? You can't stay up here for long. I'm just trying to get up on my lap. It's because Coffee Man's had to nip out to go and get them their food. Because they're starving Marvins. It's not like they've got bowls of biscuits, but she refuses to eat biscuits. But we always try and encourage her because, of course, it's good for the teeth. I have faith in everybody who wants to draw because do you know what? I just think anybody that it doesn't matter at what level or stage you are currently, the fact that you want to have a go and you pick up those pencils and you get on with it, even when you're feeling poorly, it's such a, you know, it's such a zen thing to be able to draw and enter into your own little world. That I just think it's so important. And you know, I think, and I'm the same, I'm guilty of it, you know, we all lack a bit of faith in ourselves, so it's nice when somebody has a bit of faith in you. I'm very guilty for it. Okay, so now we're looking like a much more natural, reflective surface. I was early, yeah, I did pop it in the group because I've got to log off early to do something. That's my coffee done. You don't have to watch me drink coffee anymore for this evening. Oh, my phone needs to turn me off. Okay. Okay, so I have a big favour to ask. And I know it's huge, and I know I'm being really, really cheeky, but I'm trying to reach my goals. And I can't do that without you guys. So, could you possibly, if you have a favourite already, videos that I have uploaded, just share them from YouTube? Maybe your friends and family would like them, I don't know. I'm trying to hit the next target, which is 1,600 subscribers, and I'm stuck on 1,579. So I would really, really love it if you could help. That would be amazing. Any thumbs up and any comments and any interaction on my videos means that the algorithms on YouTube, I've been such a geek and I have researched so much. But yeah, it just loves them all. So any help like that from you guys would be amazing. Well, Coffee Man is back, so hopefully it means I'll have no more meowing cat. Okay, so down by the neck here, I need to make it look like this is where when I say about, in fact, this is a really good exercise. So those of you, if you've got the time to draw along, sorry, you're going to hear the kettle going, to draw along to this, it's worth doing because you take yourself out of the element of the fact that you're drawing a dog or a person. I actually thought that was a bottle of booze then. Like a bottle of beer.
Well, you'll be lucky.
Can't drink alcohol. Because you're drawing object, you don't actually know. Your brain doesn't figure. It's really hard to explain. So when you're drawing an eye, your brain knows what an eye looks like. Your brain knows what a dog looks like and what a table looks like and things like that. But when you're drawing an object like this, you have to think a bit outside the box, and you have to step away from trying to draw an eye and only drawing what you see. And that's been my biggest argument with a lot of people, not argument, but suggestion, is that you have to stop trying to draw an eye, a dog, a table, a flamingo, and you just have to draw the shapes that you see. So in here, you've got an elongated triangle. You've got a round circle, within a round circle, within a round circle, not an eye. And this sort of project actually is really, really good for that, because it stops you from looking at it as anything but shapes and shadows and highlights. So it's really, really worth doing if you get the time to just have a go at something like this. Wear down, I need to get my glasses sorted out. I hope to visit your faith soon. Thank you. Yes, it's very hard when I feel so ill, but I need a purpose, and it's thanks to you that I'm drawing. Thank you. If I can help anyone, then I'm happy. As cheesy as it sounds, it's true. I don't give myself so freely with any other subject, because I know how, oh, it's going to sound really, really mushy now. Get the violins. I know how art makes me feel, and it makes me feel really good to be able to draw and to be able to achieve a level that I didn't think I ever could. When you make people happy, and when you get to draw for celebrities and all sorts of things, you know, it's just, even if you didn't draw for anybody else other than you, it takes you to this just zen place. I love it. It sounds like a herd of elephants are upstairs. Okay, so it looks pretty lush and clean on the page, but I can still see paper through it, so I need to keep going over and over. Oh, and a fresh coffee. Thank you very much. Okay. Isn't quite looking how I want it to here. I'm pretty sure I don't have a darker. Really annoying because I can't just pick my pink pencil pot out because they're all bottomless. So if I pick it up, it will go everywhere. I just think they're too purple. Every time I want to go dark, they start going. They start going into the purple realm, and I don't want purple. And needs pink. I was having a nuclear injection and scan today, but I don't glow. Bless you. That does not sound fun. I don't know what I did with my colour chart. Say the lighting's so bad in here with just the one light on. I think the purple red might do it. Chart's gone. Ooh, okay, that might be the colour. Let's try it. Yes, okay, there we go. that's better. I don't know how that's looking down the cap. There we go, that's better. There's 9 watching, according to my information. Blue tack, let's use blue tack. Dun, dun, dun. YouTube make it really awkward for people to comment when they're on a mobile device, which I don't know why. Which is a shame. Long gone are the 200 on Facebook and the 500,000 reach, huh? Don't get that anymore. Oh, such a lush colour. Nope. Just trying to get this neck where I'm happy, and it doesn't seem to be occurring right now, so. There's a highlight in there I've missed. Okay, so the whole of the back of this neck, basically here, there's not enough contrast between the colour variation. I'll tell you what, I'm going to use this just to take some of that purple off. I love the fact you can use these like an eraser now. So the back of this neck needs to be much darker. That's better. I always think to myself, oh, I'm getting this done quickly. And then I go back over things and over and over and over. Because that's what you do. So, shall we have a little game? Who's up for a little game? It's like a game of fastest fingers. And I think it will be hilarious. So, if you're up for a game, just type nothing but me in the comments. And if I get enough come up, if enough are willing to play, then I'll tell you the rules and we'll have a go. But I think it could be quite fun. There we go. Now we've got that much more rounded shape. Hopefully you can see that to the neck. So I'm going to use my lightest now because I just want to get that slightly different. Okay, we'll put a timer on the game as well because it might just start to get a bit boring. Right, we're getting a bit of bloom happening here, so I need to stop. We don't want no bloom. Okay, come on, Erica. So you're going to join in. Like I say, it's going to be fastest fingers wins, and I have no idea what you're going to win. Okay, let's make this a proper challenge. Okay, whoever wins a A6 signed print. What do you reckon? Erica, where have you gone? Okay, we'll give her a couple of more minutes to reply. But if any of my watchers want to have a go, and I'll pay for worldwide postage. Yeah, join in a minute. We're gonna work out what's the time. Okay, we'll start at 1:30 and we'll go to 1:45. So we'll give it 15 minutes to see who wins. I haven't told you the game rules yet. Okay, are we listening carefully? You best go now then, quick. You got till 1:30. Okay, we'll go to 1:30 and then I'll explain the rules. Go. Right, we've got loads of highlights in here. Okay, if you're watching on Facebook rather than YouTube, to join in and win the print, you will need to come and comment on YouTube. Right, hang on. Leslie has literally just asked me how they comment on YouTube. Sorry, I'm just letting her know. If you apparently, and I don't know how true this is, if you are having trouble, it's probably easier for me to say than it is to type. If you are having trouble commenting through the app, open YouTube in a browser rather than an app. Apparently, I don't know how true this is, it's easier to comment on the browser. But if you scroll down, you'll probably see a load of videos after my live feed. But if you scroll right down to the bottom, that's generally where you will find the comments. You don't find the comments directly under my video. You'll scroll down, you'll see probably 5 or 6 different videos, and then underneath that is where you see the comments. So try scrolling first. Okay, sorry, I'm just trying to explain to... Let me It doesn't help either that there's quite a long delay actually between what I say and what you hear. Hi. Right, when John's back from the powder room, I'll go through the rules. They're really, really simple rules, and it's going to be a really easy but fun game. Who knew that you were going to win goodies on tonight's live feed, huh? See, this is why you can't miss my live feeds. You miss out on all the fun. Well, I think it's going to be easier if I very gently... I know it's frustrating that obviously Facebook is far easier to do lives with regards to conversations and comments and things like that, but you know, the purpose of me doing it on YouTube is I am trying to grow the YouTube for the purpose of being able to monetize. Yeah, as I said on my other videos, and apparently I said the word translucent and I didn't mean to, I meant to say the word transparent. That's the trouble when you work with polymer clay and colouring pencils, is everything's translucent. But yeah, that is essentially what I'm trying to do. You know the old phrase, the starving artist. And while it's not true in many cases, it certainly is in others. Okay, what's the time? I don't know why I'm looking at you for the time. Okay. Ah. Good. I'm glad they put a smile on your face. Okay, if John's not back in 3 minutes, then we will crack on with the game. I suppose I can go through the rules while we're waiting. The rules are really, really simple, but the spelling isn't. Now, my kiddo calls these Flamingos. F-L-E-A, mangoes, M-A-G-O. Is there any? It is M-A-N-G-O-E-S. Flamingos. In fact, I'm going to see if I can type it. And I'm going to do it in capitals as well. Flamingos. Why is it not doing it capitals? Anyway. So, the first person to be able to write Flamingos one letter at a time. So, as you write, it will go down in the comments. So, the first person to get Flamingo written downwards wins a A6 signed print. So you have to comment F-L-E-A and carry on going down until you've written the entire word Flamingo. But you have to do it in one long run. If you get interrupted, you have to start again. Was expecting 8 p.m. again, was at work till 7:30 and hadn't... Oh, I'm sorry. That's me. Because I need to get off a bit earlier tonight. So, yeah, my apologies. Okay. Joanne's gonna win. Someone better get in there. Oh, Erica. So close, Joanne. So close. Go for it. Come on, guys. Signed A6 print up for grabs here. And I tell you what, I'll chuck in a free ACO as well. So you'll win two things, not just one. I have no idea why I'm doing it on the outside with that colour. Oh, this is brilliant. I love it. Is anybody going to win? Oh my God, look at them go. I love it. It's like a race. Brilliant. That's put a smile on my face. I think the kids are moving house upstairs. Coffee man, you may need to go and check what all that banging is. Hopefully one of them isn't trapped somewhere. Seems they should be asleep. Oh, we've got some close ones going on. Did you read the spelling, John? Because it's not... How are you... Oh, I can't even see, my eyesight's so bad. You're not allowed to do it like that. That's cheating. You got to be quickest on the draw. You got to have quick fingers. It's not, is it? I've tried it before and it really isn't easy. But it's fun. It's a fun little game. Do you know what? I think I might do this on each one of my live feeds because it's hilarious. Or I may even, if you want, if you're willing to hang on until it's done, you can actually have a signed print of the picture I'm doing on the live feed. Anybody managed it yet? I bet Joe's screaming at the screen, telling us not to type. She was so close, Erica. She literally had three. Apparently, I can't count with my fingers. Three letters to go. Just turned on and a little lost. Hi, Debbie. Okay, so we're playing a game, and whoever wins gets a signed A6 print, and you have to write, my kid calls these flea mangoes, as in flea, F-L-E-A, mangoes as in the fruit, M-A-N-G-O-E-S. So you have to write the word flea mangoes one letter at a time in the comments, and whoever gets them all in one go wins an A6 signed print. But if anybody interrupts your flow, you have to start again. And it's really hard, but it's really fun. So, and it's worldwide. So if you're anywhere out of the UK, it's fine. I'll post out. But it's good for a giggle. And it keeps you busy while I'm sitting here drawing. But if you get really cross and frustrated with it, I apologise. And I will keep an eye out. So if you are trying to ask a genuine question, stick your genuine question in there. Oh. I think I've done it. Oh, where? Oh, I don't know that you have. Where have you done it? Oh, can I scroll up before you all start scrolling down? Flea, I'm not sure you have, Leslie. Close. Between you and Joe, it's really, really close. Like, really close. Okay, so these highlights are absolutely killing me now. There's so many, they're driving me a little bit crazy. So I have to make it look like there's another, it looks like another bulbous bit. I'm not sure it is. I think it's just where the shadows are falling. It's so funny. Does everyone forget how to spell when they're typing really, really fast? This is brilliant. I'm loving this. I'll try and think of a shorter word next time. But I just thought it was appropriate with what we were drawing. Right, what I'm going to do is I'm not going to get involved too much down this half because if I have to come up and do the wing, I'm going to end up smudged. Do you know what? Through the camera, actually, that looks better than I thought it did. I'm just here laughing. See, I'm making you laugh. What more could you want on a live feed? Yeah, that's what I'm here for. And drawing, of course. And I'm supposed to be teaching you, but I'm not. I'm just giving you finger ache now. You'll be going, don't watch that, Bonnita. She makes do things. Okay, you've got four more minutes to keep trying. At quarter two, if no one wins, then we'll roll it over to the next week's live feed. You have to do some finger exercises between here and now. Now and then. P.S. If you didn't know, the sale is up and running on my Facebook page now as well. So four have gone already. My entire lip collection has gone, and all of my miniature origami animals have gone as well. So, oh, John's, oh, so close. So I want to watch what you're doing more than I want to draw now. I shouldn't have done that. I'm distracting myself. So close, John. Normality will resume at quarter two, so should you have any questions, please feel free to hold on till then. Brilliant. Oh, I love it. I really can't see. I really, really need to sort my glasses. Just another blooming expense, isn't it? Money, money, money. I've actually apparently turned myself short-sighted. I was long-sighted. But where I've been doing so much concentrating work, I've somehow managed to sort of switch it round. We are so doing this when I next do my premiere. If you're up for it, of course. I think we're definitely going to have to do this on the next premiere video. Is brilliant. Love it. Okay, let's get all this blended together, shall we? Yeah, there's no point in me doing all of the body and then coming up and then doing this back wing. I might as well try and get it all done straight away. But I'm really pleased with how shiny he's looking. Close. What I'll do is I'll go back after the live feed and double check in case I've missed it. So if anybody has one, I will let you know. Okay, you've got one more minute to try. I actually thought you typed elf there then, Leslie. This is a game I've seen them do on Instagram posts, and I just think it's so much fun and frustrating at the same time. So as I say, if no one wins tonight, I'll roll it over again. So on the next live feed, we'll only run it for 15 minutes because, of course, if there are any serious questions that need answering, we don't want them to get lost in the comments. Oh, it's between Leslie and Joe. Look, they're battling against each other. Okay, done. It's quarter two. No more trying. I will check back through the comments and see if anybody has won. But I'm pretty sure I didn't see anybody win. So it's quarter two now. You can stop now. I know there's a big delay between what I'm saying and what you're hearing. But yeah, we'll carry it on next week. That should be quite fun. Anyway, if you were waiting to ask any questions, now's the time. I can just picture you all during the week with your phones practicing typing in Flamingo. I'm going to have to show my kiddo this because she's going to be absolutely thrilled to see you all trying. Okay, we've got very tiny little dotty areas in here. Have you all got finger ache now? You're still going. Okay, so there is a tiny little this phone keeps wanting to shut down. Little spotty areas in here. I don't even think I can get them fine enough to look quite how I want them, but that's not too bad. Okay. Oh, look, Leslie, bless you. You're trying to get it in there. Anything past quarter two doesn't count. That was a giggle, wasn't it? Hopefully that's all put a smile on your face. If not, I've probably frustrated the hell out of you, and for that I apologise. But I had a giggle nonetheless. Good, I'm glad. We're going to do that more often, I think. Okay, so if anybody did have any serious questions waiting, now is the time to come and ask. I have my serious face on now. Okay, Debbie has asked, how do I achieve the high shine look? And I'll explain very briefly. I explained it all really in the first live feed. We've done this over two live feeds so far. This is the second one. We will end up going into next week as well. But the trick with high shine is it's between your shading, there's very much a stop and a start. So if we look at this bit, very conveniently placed eyebrow, but it's not, it's actually a highlight. You'll see that there's a very sharp divide between your highlight and your colour. And the thing with shiny objects is you have very much of a stop start. You don't tend to get a really gentle, smooth transition that you would with fabric or with fur or with skin tones. But even if you were doing someone with makeup on and they had that really reflective high gloss stuff on, you would still get that stop start. So when you're doing shiny objects, that's what you have to look at doing. You have to make sure that they're not necessarily crisp, but you don't get this. Sometimes you do, actually, I'll take that back. You don't very often get the ombre, the shading that you would get, as I say, with animals and skin and things like that. It is very much a highlight and then the colour and then a shadow and then the colour. So I was saying earlier that actually this is a really good training method to teach you to stop trying to draw an eye or a nose or an ear or hair, because all you have to do is look at your shapes and draw your shapes, because a lot of it doesn't make sense until you get all your shapes done and then it comes together as a whole picture. Nope, shan't. Oh dear, made me laugh. There is, didn't we do it on the Patreon, guys? I did a shiny spoon then, didn't I, on toned paper. We did a live feed on my Patreon to show you how you do a knife. And I can't show you because it's over there and I don't really want to be rude and step away from my desk. How can we be serious after that scramble? Who cares? Who needs serious? I will be serious if I need to be, though. I am here to answer people's questions. I am here to teach people and I am here to answer what I can. So in between being a really stupid fool, you've got to have fun, especially after a rainy, miserable half term day. And if I make it fun, you come back for more. If you have a chance, Debbie, check out the first live feed, because you'll see it from the very beginning. And I probably explain it a little bit better, actually, in that video, because you see very much how it progresses. So I don't know, you may find it easier, you may not. Okay, so we're going to go till 9 o'clock, so we've got another 10 minutes. As I say, the only reason, I don't know why, but this particular Pablo is really, really, really waxy. Yeah, I've got to log off early tonight, so. But we've got the whole of the neck done. We've got that back wing done. I like that. That back wing looks really lovely. And that's a back wing, not a bat wing. Do we have to? No, you don't. You can be as silly as you like. But I will bring in the naughty step if needed. So after all that silliness, for those of you who do want to know, and I haven't mentioned it yet, I'm using Strathmore 300 series Bristol board, and I happen to have an A4 pad, which I got from Angela at Paper Story. I like it because it's really smooth, but it's got a little bit of texture, enough that I can, you know, get a good bit of colour off of my pencil. And I'm using the Caran d'Ache Pablos, and I'm using the Faber-Castell Polychromos. As I had failed to mention that in the video earlier. Who knew that you lot were so competitive? I'm really, really pleased with how he's coming out. That neck, I wasn't expecting that neck to come out like that, but I'm quite happy. The blending here I'm a little bit annoyed about, but I'll come back and fix that when I can take a bit of a step back from it. So his little tail, I might get his little tail done actually. Be nice to get that done. Right, I need to sharpen the nib, the lead. Oh, do you know what? That's quite tricky because actually it depends on your paper. For blending, I really like the luminance because it's really, really creamy and it blends together everything well. But you're essentially doing a saturation burnish, which means that you reduce the colour saturation. So you tend to have to go over the top, but it does give you a really beautiful blend. On the toned paper, I actually find the white Pablos really, really good because they're in between the softness of the Polychromos and the luminance. I find that they work really well on the toned paper. But I would probably say my go-to is the luminance. And I find that I can get luminance over standard colours as well, so I don't have to worry about pushing really, really hard to try and get it. But then I tend to leave negative space when I need highlights anyway. So really, it's just for shading and blending. But yeah, get one of all three. It's always worth having a little extra because you're never going to know when you're going to need them. Okay, so we've got a nice shadowy bit here. He's got such a cute little tail. I didn't even think, do they have tails? Well, I suppose they do. They fly, so they have to. I'm going to have to go Google flamingo anatomy later. Oh, well, there you go. You're sorted then. I've heard a few people go on about... Oh, I can't think of the brand. China White. But I haven't tried that one myself. Right, I need to go darker on this back bit. Now remember, if your highlights are not showing, it's not because you haven't gone light enough, it's because, Erica, you haven't gone dark enough. And PS, I said nothing about going dark on that picture you shared earlier because actually I thought it was bloody brilliant. No tail, it's a rudder. It's a rudder? We do like flamingos. Okay. We are going to scrape the highlight off here because I forgot to leave it. It's only a tiny little highlight on there, so I've just got to shrink that down. I was doing trying to get another commission done today. Actually, I managed to finish one, Maria's one, which I nearly spilt half a freaking cup of coffee over, and I have never done that before, so I'm really cross with myself. It was pooling towards the picture. And I had a piece of blank paper on the desk, luckily, and I just literally got this blank paper and shoved as much of this liquid on the floor as possible, and it worked, luckily. But this has had to come out again for the other... Why can't I talk today? For the other commission that I'm doing, so... You know, it's look, so you can see how smooth that blending is when you can actually look with a magnifying glass and you can't see the paper through it. So that's how smooth that blending is. Good, huh? Derwent, aha. I bought the Derwent Chinese white to use on my white, but not done any since I got it. So how did you find it? Okay, his shape's a little wrong there. I need to do that. I'll stop blowing, such a bad habit. Never blow on your work. Okay, we haven't done too bad. I've managed to do the neck, the rudder, and that back wing. I really love the way he's turning out. Be hard for really fine details. Ah, yeah, see, that's where the luminance, I think, comes in. But then I'm a negative space girl, so I do try and leave the negative space for the highlights. The other thing is to remove some of it with, if you've got a Tombow, remove it with your Tombow and then you can go in afterwards with your white. But the trick is definitely to leave, why am I going over a highlight? To leave negative space like I've been doing on this Flamingo. Because there's nothing more irritating than trying to get a highlight in after the fact. Just makes life harder. But I do recommend the slice tool though, if you are looking at adding some really fine detail highlights, because it is really, really good. I'll see if you want me to, I can get a proper review done of the slice knife and both of them actually, both of the ones I've got. If you want to see it more in action with regards to things like fur detail and things like that. I'll be more than happy to get a review video up at some point. Okay, highlight in there, one there, and one in there. I think I've got to one too many, but as I say, I am not looking forward to the other wing. There is so many highlights on there. I haven't, no. It is one that I want to try. It's the liquid pen, isn't it? The only thing that worries me about using those, if I'm thinking of the right one, is the yellowing. I used to be one for using pen all the time for doing highlights, but it just, the worry of everything going yellow. Okay, if you have wanted to ask a question but you don't because it's live, I don't mind at all. Please pop the question down in the comments after the live feed if you want. If you're not a member already, I have a group on Facebook called Bonnita Doodles Art Share, where we just share anything arty or crafty. It doesn't have to be drawing, doesn't matter what your level is. Yeah, come and join in. It's a nice friendly group. If you haven't already, hit subscribe to the channel and hit the bell button to be notified. But I am live every Wednesday, and I'm going to say now anywhere between 7:30 and 8 o'clock, but generally it's 8 o'clock. Yeah, that's the thing, is the archival. I'm going to carry on now. Yeah, the archival quality always worries me when it comes to paint, even paint markers and acrylic pens. You do need to be careful. That's the only thing. But yeah, if you haven't been able to ask a question, if you're watching this later and I'm not live anymore, thank you for watching. Thumbs up is really, really appreciated. But pop a comment below and I will get back to you and I will answer what I can. And if there's anything you want to me to review or any future videos you'd like to see from me, again, just pop it in the comments below and I will be happy to have a look and I will see if I can oblige. But thank you very much for joining me this evening. I'm pretty pleased with how much we got done. And yeah, I shall see you on the next video. Have a good evening, everybody. And yeah, enjoy the rest of the night. Bye.